this is the dwarf playing games while rambling incoherently into the microphone. Why? Well, just because I can. We're about to enter the Shale Bridge Cradle.
Cradle. It used to be an insane asylum, and before that, it was an orphanage. One night a fire started, no one knows how, and after that, they left the place abandoned. If there's a way to cram more misery into one building's history, I can't think of it. I'm here to learn about the old woman who attacked me in the Keeper compound. Drept said he saw the hag here at the orphanage long ago, when his childhood friend was murdered. He's never dared to come back, but I don't think I have much choice. It's a thin lead, but it's all I have left. I've never robbed an orphanage before, and I can't say I'm looking forward to this visit. There's no telling what I'll find inside. I'm used to the dark, but this feels like a house with bad dreams.
That was quite a poetic turn of a phrase from Garrett. Again, 90% of loot, 3 special items. Going to be a hassle probably, judging from the past, but oh well. I think I am closer to the end than I am to the beginning now. Like way past half of the game. So, let us see what the Cradle has in store. To be honest, a building which was first an orphanage and, or was it the other way around? First the insane asylum and then the orphanage is like a creepy concept in and of itself, like even without all the like the fire and the whatever, even if it was like a well-run insane asylum and a well-run orphanage, it's still like an iffy combination to me. Do I have a map? No, I don't. It's a pity. Okay, the main doors are boarded up. There is a way to the basement here, but I will try to explore the grounds first. Behind me. Like, that's a staple of haunted houses. Wow, so apparently it was, at least for a time, it was both an insane asylum and an orphanage, which is like bollocks, to be honest. Nobody is Nobody should be supposed to deal with that. Okay, I'm not sure which way. Is that a wail of the undead or just an ambient noise? Restoring the power, probably.
She looks familiar. It's that keeper translator girl. But that can't be. This portrait must be as old as the building.
I can hear you breathing. Nobody here in the cradle does that anymore. How did you get in? My name is Laurel. Something changed when you saw my picture. That's why you can hear me now. I want to leave here, but I can't. The cradle won't let any of us go. Will you help me? They filled up a bottle with my blood. It's down in the storm cellar. It's very dark down there. Please find the bottle and drop it into a drain pipe so it will end up outside. It's important.
Isn't that her blood as well? Although I guess it must be old by now and dried up. I didn't notice that at first. Did they murder a girl straight in this place? Okay, let me see it. So, storm cellar. So somewhere cellar. So in the like downstairs. I'm not sure. Like cellar is British and basement is American, I think. For an underground storage thing. The treasurer's office probably may have some valuables. Not as much as I wanted, but apparently there is not that much loot, because that's already 9%. But well, I would think a mission like that isn't about the loot, really. Okay, let me see what they have to say. Heat therapy. Like almost like a, although I guess that depends how hot they're talking about, because it brings to my mind like when they talk about laying, you know, hot stuff on you, It brings stuff like branding to my mind, but I guess it depends on how hot they're talking about. Okay. I will go down first because I think a cellar is supposed to be down. Okay, I came from here, it's still open, so kind of a good sign. Read this before. This looks like the drain pipes. Again, this is further down. The generator is kind of scary. Okay, these seem like vials of blood. Which is also kind of like weird. Why would you even do that? It reeks of like occult ritual stuff. That was that a baby crying? Okay. Oh. Oh. Maybe it's like. Scripted to react to the story because one patient apparently carries an urn of her child's ashes.
This one must be hers. It's still warm. Great.
That's the cage where they used to put the new patients until a cell opened up. You should stay out of there, or the cradle might see you and try to keep you here forever.
Okay, I must put the... what's it? The blood into the drain pipe. Which I assume is somewhere over here. Like this looks like a reservoir for... another patient history. I wonder if like, that's a euphemism for something? Although I'm not sure what, but I'm not sure why it is in quotations. I hope it's not like a birdhouse made out of human remains or something. Although I wouldn't rule it out at this point. Okay, where is the... drop it down the drain pipe. Drain pipe, drain pipe in the lobby, so not here. So the lobby should be like a main area.
Cradle can't see it. I have to get rid of all my things. The cradle uses them to remember me. That's how it keeps me here. There's a ward here called Whitehall where they kept the very bad patients. One of them took my nightgown back to his cell. It's still there. Please get my nightgown and then burn it up in the morgue.
Sadly, at some point in history, there was a staple of regular hospitals as well. I think, like, it was either dozens of thousands or even hundreds of thousands of people that were lobotomized, in line with the current understanding of medicine. It was thought a beneficial practice, even though it's basically, like, mutilation. Okay, silver surgical kit in the lobotomy theater. Oh great, we'll keep the training to a minimum. What a bunch of nut jobs. Valuable. Okay, so that's the second of the special items, no doubt. Storm cellar. Wait, wasn't I here? Ah, maybe it's emergency lockdown. Okay, so this will open this door, but I'll try to search the other part first. Ah, so this must be the main entrance then. Before going, okay, so this is back here. But I think this only leads to the attic. Yeah, right. Ah, okay. This is like a different... Okay, so bag of gold teeth in the morgue. Good to know. So that should cover all the special items. Okay, so I need to find my way to the morgue, as well as the lobotomy theater. I guess it must be this one. Staff tower. Except sorry, it's here already. It looks more like a prison to me, but was moving too fast to be a zombie. Okay, I already got this one from the treasurer. What is that sound? It's like a clock? Zombie with those cages around its head and hands, and it has like a very jittery quality to its movements, which makes it even more creepy. I wonder if maybe those are some valuables around here. Seems like gemstones or something. Oh, did someone like tear the eyes out of every portrait, stamp them with blood, and then put gemstones in them? Well, if anything, it's kind of creative. Yeah, it looks like it. Sure, if regular holy water would be enough to deal with them. Oh, damn it. I'm quite sure. Come here, right. Saved in quite a while, I'm afraid. Oh no, I actually did, so I guess it's as good of a time as any to test that holy water hypothesis. To disintegrate, so I have a nasty feeling he will stand up in the end. Nothing in here. Oops. Seems I. So dark, I can't even. Are those? Yeah, those are gas arrows. Unlikely to be useful against the zombies in particular, but. Something. Your home. various cells. I wonder if the patients are inside. Because if yes, then they probably won't appreciate me breaking in. Ashes in a cradle, which is like both really creepy and really sad. Can I take it? Does not seem like it. This book, all of records. Okay, I didn't really foresee that. So perhaps I should. The loot first, so then I can only concentrate on. Okay, it was here before. Then I can only concentrate on the plot related. For a moment there, I was scared of my own shadow. Seclusion chamber. Well, that's like solitary, I guess.
He heard me come in and started making screaming noises. I think he wanted me to help him, but I was too afraid.
Okay, so I guess this is like used for the water therapy or something. I thought it might be a section table for, like a dissection table for the mod, but. This must be the wax mask they talked about in one of the. Oh, this looks like a surgery table up there, which is where I can find the silver surgical kit. Okay, so at least there is not that much loot in here. Let me read this. I'm uneasy by how they put botched in quotation marks here. Okay, now, logically, the morgue should probably be somewhere nearby, because when your subjects die, patients, whatever you call them. I guess patients is a lot nicer. But when your patients die, you would like there to be a place nearby where you can store the bodies. Okay, I think I will dump this one. Although, I probably should be more stingy with my holy weight. Wait. Just needs to be placed with the other. I don't think there's anything here, to be honest, because it just leads to the place where I just was with the guy pretending to eat or whatever. This is the morgue. I guess if they are alert, they take more punishment. Use of that, so I will try to maybe hit him in the back when his back is turned or something, because the previous one went down after only one flask of holy water, so. Save on that holy water I just wasted on the guy. Because it may just happen, I don't really need to down him right now. Especially if he gets back up later. Suspicion this one will end up if I come closer. It's not, not like I have much choice there, because he seems to be on like a proximity alert or something, and he's like laying exactly where I need to go. Problematic to say the least. Second one here. Like, I think it was this one in particular, not the one on the left. But he Even if it was the one on the left, still, I think it will get back right as I step to the check. Oh no, it was this one. So the one on the left after all. But it doesn't help me as much as I would like it to. I wonder if it will ever, like, get back on its own. Then maybe I should down it again. It will stay down for a moment at least. Okay, don't leave. Valuables and just vials of blood from the patients, presumably. Yeah, I have little idea how to deal with that, to be honest. Because I don't think. Kinda worked, but so maybe I'll throw one. If I manage to down the one that is walking with just one vial, if caught unaware, then I can use the second one on the one laying on the ground, pick up the teeth, and go away, and still have two vials left. I'd like to have more, but somehow I doubt I will find any in this accursed place. Doesn't seem to be particularly holy or anything. Although the problem is, like the one, I think if I down, even if I down this one, this one will get up when it hears its scream. Maybe you won't. Okay. Unfortunately, that's really all of them. I wonder if I can maybe shoot them with fire arrows? Okay, I can actually use this maybe now. Get back to the high level. Because I need to find what was called that level. Don't mind me. Whitehall, yeah, right. And some loot as well. If I had a map of the place, anyone was here before. actually was here as well. Is there, maybe? Okay, meal hall. It up, but ah, okay, I'm just carrying it and it's not showing down there. It's the jittery movement that does it for me, like, it makes it even more creepy, because it's really inhuman. This was the like a walking area. Oh no, this this is the secluded chamber. Okay, I will check the solitary, if only to see if there is like loot there or something. It was really close. This is okay, okay, that's very good. As I said, I will check the solitary if only because. Well, I guess it's just a. Not sure. Because it's not the elevator I used last time, I don't think so at least. I still need the loot, and as I said, I would like to complete the loot requirement before. Makes sense for there for there not to be a second set of buttons if it's supposed to be a solitary cell. Of course. So point for you, game designers. It's an awfully high place to drop from, to be honest. It's really a marvel how much you can change the atmosphere by making the light flicker. It's still a light and it's still quite bright, but I think this is the took the gun, so I suppose it will be in one of the cells. Thought it wouldn't follow up on the lead, but flash bombs perhaps work on it. Might be good to test because I have a lot of those. probably best to pick the lock in small increments. This guy seems to be like a cannibal or something. Lovely. There's still some loot missing. Because it said Whitehall here, didn't it? Yeah, so I'm not sure where the Whitehall begins and where it... It was said to house the most dangerous inmates, and one of them has the nightgown that I need. But there was nothing in this cell, I don't think. Also, that's what I was afraid is going to happen. I guess the game will have me search all the cells in the end, so maybe it doesn't matter. Which way I go about it. You can see it through the window here. To be honest, I feel much safer if I just downed it, but I may yet need the holy water. not sure how far does it go before returning. And the background noises don't help, to be honest. Slightest. With the heart noise, like, is it like one of those situations like in the telltale heart in which there's a like a person buried under the cell or something, or behind the wall? Okay, I would really like to pick that up, game. The loot. Oh, although, because it said one of the patients is used to carry an unlit candle, so that may be it, actually. Maybe like a quest item for later or something. Wasn't the best thing I've done in my life. First or something. because this is the toolbox we were talking about in one of the... So I guess probably in the later stage of the quest I will have to pick up all those special items for one reason or another. Okay, save. Searching for me there or just blocked? Oh, it turned.
Those bricks look a little uneven. Someone did some amateur work.
Okay, that's the...
The staff blamed him for what happened to me. They were wrong.
Still need the loot. I can probably pick some more cells on my way there. Just to check them for loot. And the ambient is really doing its job. Okay, I wonder if there's a second one patrolling here or only... Really cool how the ambient noises change in each cell depending on the history and, you know, the patient that was in there. I think it was this way to the morgue. And there is still like a nursery tower that I haven't checked, so that's maybe where I will find the missing loot. Thank you. good to see those two are still down. No doubt they will get up eventually. Is the morgue, isn't it?
You did it! My nightgown's gone. But the cradle remembers more than I thought. You can't get it all here. You have to go into the past, into the cradle's memories. It's the only way. You'll have to pretend to be one of the patients so the cradle won't see you. Each of the patients from Whitehall had a favorite toy that they liked. You can use them as keys to go into the cradle's memories. Find one of those toys, and I'll tell you what to do next.
Okay. Although maybe it would be prudent if I checked the nursery tower first to get the hang of the loot. Used to leave, apparently. Though, there's not much left of this place, is it? It seems if it has crumbled down to ruin, which is unfortunate because I really hoped there'd be some loot here. Sounded like it saw me, but maybe it didn't. I kind of... It isn't that I wasn't expecting that, it's I was a little lost in thought.
I think he used to eat with those in the meal hall. The toy you just picked up is a key to the cradle's memories. Now you have to figure out where to bring it. There's a special place for each toy. When you put the toy in the right place, you'll enter the past.
Hey, so obviously the eating utensils probably belong in the meal hall here. Somewhere.
This is what everything looks like, the way the cradle remembers it. It's like a stitch in time. You can't die here because you're inside a patient. But if the staff catch you, they'll take away your toy and you'll have to find another one. Now will you get my diary? In the real world, it's all torn apart and we never find all the pages. But in the past, it's just the way I left it. Up in the nursery tower. Please find it and burn it in the morgue.
Okay. I think the nursery tower was this way.
Though, if you find another toy and bring it to the right place, you can go back into the past. But don't break all the toys, or you'll have to go into the past as your real self. If you go to the Hall of Records, you can read about all the patients. She danced for us in the old puppet theater. It's the lobotomy room now.
Okay. Now where was that? Not 100% sure.
Okay.
unfortunate. Good to learn where the tunnel would be for later. Really good at remembering which way to go. Oh no, this is the lava tunnel. So it's a pity I didn't take the gramophone with me then. If this was the okay, so I will take the gramophone because it's really close. The tower is over there. It's really close, so allow me to not have to walk too far away. First, I need to find it again.
She used to play that when she danced for us in the old puppet theater. It's the lobotomy room now.
Again, it's the same situation as before, I think. No longer sure. Yeah, I think it's going to spot. halfway, okay. Maybe I'll just wait here until it passes. I mean, I don't have to, I could, you know, run around and hide and go back again and stuff, but doesn't seem to be the wisest idea or the easiest. To be honest, I'm not sure I can even bypass that guy. It would be too easy if I just could. Thank you.
Oh.
I wonder if the other guy will still be there. The one that was sort of like pretending to be eating garbage or remains or whatever that was supposed to be. Because if he does, then it will be really difficult to get through here. Oh, those are probably towels, now that I think about it. Yeah, it was somewhere very close to the surgery room, so probably this way. This is the nursery tower. So I need to go to the nursery tower, right? Okay. I probably need to go further up because this place in the real time is destroyed. The staircase. It's like perhaps it would be more intellectually honest to just keep burning through the special items, trying every other time, but I'm afraid I don't really fancy that too much. I'm afraid it saw me. Though maybe it didn't. For one, I will use like an alternative save or something. Just
started letting the patients stay here, there wasn't enough room for everybody. All of us children had to move here into the nursery tower, where the babies used to be. When they started letting the patients stay here, there wasn't enough room for everybody. All of us children had to move here into the nursery tower, where the babies used to be.
Returned here. I think. Like, what happens if I get caught after I get it but before I burn it? Do I need to burn it in the past or just get transported with me to the present? I guess the best objective will tell me if that should happen. It's safe to use the quick save again. Thank you. think I should be able to. I think I was able to mantle up here the entire time. I wonder how many items does she have laying around. Come on, move. Facing the ladder, so I'm afraid it will see me if I try to. Although, on the other hand, it can't follow me there, so. Okay, it didn't tell me, like, apparently I need to be in the past, after all. I really hope I have the proper save, because if not, then I will have to do that all over again. Not that far away, so. To save, to be honest. Not it was a safe place. Not. This seems to be a little safer. If he went right to the right there again. Instead of going in a small circle. But that's apparently what his life plan is now. Records.
Good. The cradle can barely remember me anymore. But it can still see the bloodstain in the attic. You'll need to clean it up in the past, where it's always fresh. Sometimes when the staff took patients to a treatment room, they wouldn't ever come back. They used something called dissolution serum to clean up afterward. Get it, and then use it on my bloodstain in the attic. Where I saw you the first time.
Okay. Thank you. this is the surgery room. And I think the treatment room was nearby. This is the right room. Supposed to be in here. Okay, but that's only one of the treatment rooms. So there is probably to be honest, I don't remember where the second treatment room was. Unless the long-term theater counted as a treatment room. Or maybe it's like on the other. Okay, this seems like a possible here on the right, there was like a bottle. that might as well be blood. Not quite sure. Okay, I seem to have blocked myself. Now to the attic, although I'm still missing a small bit of loot. I hope I will maybe find it on my way out somewhere, if like a new place opens up or something. And then higher to the attic. Thank you. too close. It's the wrong way anyway, I think. Yeah, it's a... I think this is the right way. I'm not 100% sure about that. Yeah, I remember walking near that furnace when I first entered the place.
You did it! The cradle can't remember me anymore. We can leave now. Meet me in the lobby. I'll show you the way out.
Okay. There's still... I'm missing some loot. I really hope I will find it on my way out, because... Thank you. here, actually. At first I felt it was one of the enemies.
Oh no! You can't leave, can you? I know why. This place remembers you now. You've been here too long. There's only one way to leave the cradle. You have to trick it. I'll help you. First, you have to enter the past as your real self. There's a cage in the storm cellar. You have to go inside it and close the door. Then you'll enter the cradle's memories as your real self. But you can't let the staff find you. If they catch you this time, you'll be dead forever. This is a different time, just before the end. You look like yourself now, and the cradle can see you. If the staff find you, they'll kill you. There's one last thing you have to do. Go to the top of the staff tower. There's an open window up there. You have to jump out. Then the cradle will think you killed yourself, but you won't really die. You'll just be outside where it can't see you. I'll be waiting for you.
Nothing really sort of creepy. I probably won't be able to do it until I pick up the loot. Oh god. I don't remember where the staff tower is, to be honest.
Oh!
The staff tower. Nobody is allowed up there.
Something tells me there's no coming back. I should finish everything else I've got to do first.
Like, I wonder, can I even see loot in my sort of I think I will revert to my sort of normal self, try to find the missing loot and then go back again. Okay, it's still before I burned the, I mean, cleaned the blood. It shouldn't be that much of a hassle to do it again.
You did.
trap through here.
You now. You've been here too long. There's only one way to leave the cradle. You have to trick it. I'll help you. First, you have to enter the past as your real self. There's a cage in the storm cellar. You have to go inside it and close the door. Then you'll enter the cradle's memories as your real self. But you can't let the staff find you. If they catch you this time, you'll be dead forever.
She's no longer in the portrait now that the cradle has forgotten her. Maybe there's something on that balcony I once was at. But it was in the past, so... But first I will check the This is the staff tower.
That's the staff tower. Nobody is allowed up there. He wore that mask to hide his burns. he was locked in the seclusion chamber.
Okay, but I don't actually... need that. I need to check all the cells again. Afraid to look inside.
She carried that jar around like it was a real baby in the exercise yard.
Okay, I didn't really... At this point I am...
She used to feed birds with that. They let her hang it from the balcony.
Okay. Then to the storm cellar now.
This is a different time, just before the end. You look like yourself now, and the cradle can see you. If the staff find you, they'll kill you.
Put me right next to the... within...
There's one last thing you have to do. Go to the top of the staff tower. There's an open window up there. You have to jump out. Then the cradle will think you killed yourself, but you won't really die. You'll just be outside where it can't see you. I'll be waiting for you.
Okay, this is the staff tower.
Something tells me there's no coming back. I should finish everything else I've got to do first.
What are you talking about? Oh god, there's still like a... For the love of... And I have saved him... My god... I've already saved in the past as my real self, so... Not even sure if I can find the info while I'm in the past. Okay, I have checked, and apparently I can, or even must, find the info on the hag in the past. I checked because, like, I'm not in the mood for, you know, searching for it for half an hour and then learning that I can't even find it in the, mode I'm currently in. To be honest, like, it's a great mission, but I'm a little done with it at this point. Although it's more of a fault of the loot requirements from the expert difficulty than it is of the mission objectives themselves. Because it's really, really annoying to, you know, be missing some small quantity of loot and you can't progress because you're just looking for like 20 gold pieces or something ridiculous like that. I don't even care for hiding now. Well, funnily enough, that might have worked better now that I didn't even try. This already. it's also...
I was playing hide and seek with my friend Drapt, but he never found me. Instead, the Grey Lady found me. I tried to run, but the door was locked, and I couldn't.
Okay, that kind of didn't work. I wanted to read it, in full, in order not to have to read it later. But I think I will have to do some honest to God. Oh God, I kind of... Okay, I think I have... okay, the quick save should be the highest one. Load, yes, should be. If I delete it, I would be like, for God's sake. Okay, where am I?
I was playing hide and seek with my friend Drapt, but he never found me. Instead, the Grey Lady found me. I tried to run, but the door was locked, and I couldn't get it open.
Okay, I would think I will just make a run for it now, because... To be honest, that was mostly pointless because it didn't tell me anything new. The only thing it sort of told me is the thing that Drapt has already told me. There weren't even any new details or anything. Okay, I just need to find the window. Make a run for it.
I finally managed to escape from that place, but I think I'm out of my depth here. I saw an old portrait of a girl who looks just like that keeper translator. But how can that be? I only found traces of the hag. I don't think she's been there since Drept saw her all those years ago. So I'm left with questions, and the vial of blood the ghost had me steal. The ghost is beckoning. I think I'd better follow. This isn't over yet.
Over an hour of reloads. Okay, I will actually.
I'd better not try this alone.
I will actually save here and end the episode. So, because it was like 3 hours, so it's more of a movie than an episode, really. Anyway, see you in the next one. Bye.